Hey, on today's Daily Sprint, we're talking about increasing our purpose, passion, and meaning. And we, all good times come to an end. We're coming to the end. Actually just finished it today. Think Again by Adam Grant. Definitely, I wish I would have read this 15 years ago. But I'm gonna read just a quick passage and then we're gonna get into what we're talking about today. So he says, when we dedicate ourselves to a plan that isn't going as we hoped, our first instinct isn't usually to rethink, it's instead we double down and sink more resources into the plan. And he talks about how misdirected grit could be a bad thing. So I'm gonna go over two beliefs that as I was growing as an entrepreneur that I put all kinds of grit into that actually was sinking my business or being a bad allocation of resources. So, and you might be doing the same, and again, I wish I would have known this 10 years ago. Number one, so we do health coaching and Macro Millionaire, so obviously it's gonna attract people who are, in the working out, in the health and fitness, and that's the avenue that we use to help others get healthy and fit to make money. So for me, growing up as a nutrition coach, I thought, hey, I've got to look uber ripped. Not, being in shape is okay, but I have to be like mega jacked. So I went and actually took it to the extreme, and I did these bodybuilding shows, which I may continue to do one day. We promote two bodybuilding shows. That's beyond the point. But anyway, so I took it to the extreme because I'm like, oh, I gotta get ripped. And really what I was doing, I was just deflecting because that was all on me, okay? I was putting all this grit into my workouts, into my nutrition. And actually that was deterring more people than helping. Yeah, I'd get like a few dudes in the gym that'd be like, I wanna get jacked like you, man. I'll be like, oh, cool, I do coaching. They're like, man, we ain't got no money. The people who I really wanted to help were like the moms, the dads, my grandma, the people on walkers, people that needed help, who also had the resources to hire me to help them. But I was so caught up into looking the part instead of helping other human beings that my grit, you only have so much grit, went like 80% into me and 20% into maybe getting new clients. And then when I would put myself in front of Mr. and Mrs. Jones, they would take one look at me and be like, no, that is so unobtainable. All I wanna do is keep up with my grandchildren. I'm gonna find someone else. And they would find a more normal coach. So not saying that, I could have went a different direction. I just really didn't wanna help the elitists of the world. I didn't wanna help someone, go from 97% to 98%. I wanted to help someone go to 20% to 60 or 80%. Man, that was my client avatar. So I had to change those allocation of resources over time. Not saying that, I couldn't compete ever again. I just had to reallocate a lot of that grit over into helping the type of client that I wanted. So I had to take it off me and into the person that I was looking to pursue. Number two, man, I did a lot of this, is I've got to know the part. So the first is I've got to look the part. The second is I've got to know the part. So what I would do is I'd get all these certifications, one right after another. But what did that do? That took a lot of studying, it took a lot of grit, it took a lot of focus onto a piece of paper that did really nothing. I didn't need none of this knowledge of the piece of paper. I never had a client like not hire me because they're like, hold on, are you NASM, ISSA? Oh, what about your NSCA? Did you get that one? I was like, yes, I did. But nobody cares how much you know until they know how much you care. And at that point, they still don't care how much you know. They just care that you can help them get to point A to point B. Nobody asked. My wife just got her PhD in holistic nutrition. We're not like, whoa, the floodgates are open. Everyone's hiring us right now. PhD. No, that was something she wanted to pursue, higher education. But here's the thing. She spent 80% of her time trying to help others and 20% of that time on PhD. Okay, so that is kind of the point. Definitely not saying we don't have hobbies as coaches or as entrepreneurs. Of course we do. But it's when we allocate our time, energy, and resources into the wrong areas of our business, that's when our business starts to not be what we hoped it would be. That's when we're like, man, I got in this to help people. I'm not helping anyone. I got in this to make money. I got in this to help my kids get through college, and none of that's happening. Look at where you're allocating your resources. Are you playing that perfectionist role because you think that you have to? Or really it's just cloaking our ability to get to work, to get people, get in their inbox, get on the phone with people, put our light out there, share that light to other people, prospect. So hopefully this made sense to everyone. Would love to know if it is making an impact on you. Let me know in the comments, and have a great growth-driven rest of your day.